In the wake of the super cold, this week's Gardening 101.
I didn't see that. That's not good.
The coldest temperatures in over 70 years have taken its toll on the North Texas landscape.
Your freeze damage actually inside the tissue where that moisture froze, and you see the stems or this trunk start to split.
So this weeping redbud, a tree retailing about $200, is dead. Not everything is.
Hopefully, on a lot of them, we can just prune back that damage and they'll recover. But if the damage is too significant, we may end up losing the plants.
About that pruning, wait. Those damaged leaves and stems are actually protecting what is still alive.
This is actually working as a little bit of an insulated layer, and we don't want to expose any of the green tissue underneath to any cool or freezing temperatures going forward this spring.
For bushes and plants that are typically green in the winter and are likely now looking brown or pale, the hope is that very soon they drop off.
Leaf drop in evergreens is actually a good sign after this freeze event.
This means the plant is still alive and trying to recover. While most plants you want to wait till spring, plants like yuccas and agaves need to be cut back now.
And that's one of the plants that we can actually prune now. Unfortunately, if majority of the tissue is mushy, the plant may not survive.
Cut back on all the discolored areas trying to keep the original leaf shape. If left on, it will only rot quickly in the warmer weather. Spring is starting soon. Your plants will soon show what parts, if any, survived. It is to be a spring of hope, a Gardening 101.
If you have a question about your garden, go to our website, cbsdfw.com. Click onto the weather page, and there you will find the Gardening 101 link. Submit your question. We'll try to find you an answer.